For prosecutors, it's an unusual but not unprecedented step.
Charging suspected dealers with manslaughter. News 5's Brian Hamrick is live tonight with how one prosecutor is trying to curb a growing epidemic. Brian?
Yeah, Cheryl, heroin use has increased at an alarming rate. For people being treated, it's now more of a problem than alcohol, cocaine, and marijuana combined. Today, an effort to battle the problem by taking on the dealers.
In rural Clermont County,
it's small town.
People feel welcome. What's not is something many here thought was gone for good 30 years ago.
It's back, and I don't know how it got started.
Heroin is back from the past, but as deadly as ever. A graphic reminder at this Williamsburg restaurant where investigators say a well-liked 21-year-old named Shane Richardson pulled into a parking spot and overdosed on heroin. Now a message is going out to suspected dealers from prosecutors here. The man accused of selling the drug to Richardson, Alex Deal, and the man who allegedly sold Deal the heroin, Keith Whalen, are not only charged with drug trafficking, but with involuntary manslaughter. Not unprecedented, but an unusual step to battle a drug that is rampant.
Well, it's huge, and what we're seeing are more people looking for treatment. There's less treatment available.
Steve Walkenhorst is with the Center for Chemical Addiction Treatment in Cincinnati. He says the numbers are startling. Just 4 years ago, heroin was the drug of choice for 27% of those treated. This year, it's 61%.
People in rural areas may have to drive a little further to get it, but it's everywhere.
Some police departments tell us that heroin is now linked conservatively to 75% of crimes like copper thefts, burglaries, and car break-ins, a ripple effect from a drug that's on the comeback trail and leaving a trail of death.
Now, close to half of the heroin users today are between the ages of 18 and 30. Cheryl?
So, Brian, these suspected dealers are charged in the victim's death. Can this be proven?
Yeah, well, each case is different, and getting a conviction, that can be difficult. But if nothing else, this sends a message that they're trying to make these dealers understand this is going to be a very serious problem. They're going to pursue this very seriously. Cheryl?
Okay, Brian Hamrick reporting. Thank you.